Welcome to the session on Effective Advertising, Creative Message Execution and Brand Bonding. Friends, effectiveness in advertising is a crucial task for marketer. Creating effective advertisements entails far more than merely having a great product or a clever slogan. The creative process of advertising requires careful planning regarding the important facets of advertisements and commercials. Each advertisement consists of various elements that are integrated to form a coherent message that will reach the target audience and persuade the consumer to make a decision to purchase the product. Organizations employ creative strategies to develop effective advertising messages. Creative brief is also important as the copy platform or message strategy brief and a blueprint of what the company plans to achieve with its advertising message. Friends, brand bonding through emotional message execution plays very important role in effective advertising. This session would focus upon appeals, format, body copy, and all other important aspects of creative message execution along with brand bonding through emotional message execution. Now, let's see what are the objectives of the session. The objectives are to make you understand creative brief, to make you learn execution styles of creative brief, to make you understand the concept of advertising appeals, to understand the impact of message execution in brand bonding, to make you understand the elements of preparing creative brief. Let's start with understanding advertising message and importance. Friends, every element of the advertising message is carefully planned and executed. Advertisers employ different executional frameworks and advertising appeals to reach the target audience with a persuasive message that contains both verbal and visual aspects. The verbal elements refers to the text or copy of the advertisement, and the visual aspect relates to the illustrations, pictures or models, which may include characters used in the message. It should be noted that the term model in the context here refers to any women depicted in an advertisement or commercial, and not only to the women depicted as fashion models. Various strategies exist that can be used to combine the verbal and visual elements to form a message that will resonate with the target audience. An effective advertising message is not only original but also strategically apt for the objectives and target market of the organization. Additionally, an effective advertisement also needs to be creative. Advertising creativity goes hand in hand with the tactical choices the organization makes in terms of the right message, the choice of media, and how the advertisement will be presented. Friends, an organization that is creative in its advertising is able to generate unique, original ideas that will satisfy marketing communication needs. Let's understand now the creative brief. A creative brief is also referred to as the copy platform or message strategy brief, and is a blueprint of what the company plans to achieve with its advertising message. Various advertising agencies use different formats of the creative strategy brief. The communication problem or issue, which refers to the problem that needs to be resolved, such as low brand awareness. The objectives for the message are what the organizations want to achieve with the advertisement. The objective, for example, to persuade the audience to try the product is linked to the method that will be used to reach it, like demonstrations. For example, given by O. Gwin in 2009. The target audience refers to a detailed description of the target market. For example, Revlon may wish to target females between the ages of 18 and 30 with their advertisement for a new lipstick. The importance benefits that will be communicated, that is major selling idea. The organization must find the USP, that is unique selling proposition, which is major advantage of the brand. This is an advantage which is not offered by the competition and should therefore attract a large number of customers. The advertiser can develop a strong brand image through image advertising. Friends, finding the unique characteristic of the brand that causes the customer to buy it. This is also referred to as finding the inherent drama, according to Belkin-Belk. The creative strategy statement consists of advertising theme, that is the execution styles and the advertising appeals. Friends, the advertising theme is the general idea that runs through the campaign and relates to the central message of the brand as told by Klo and Beck. The supporting information for the advertisement claims in the message includes the factors that back up the promise of the brand. An example is the unique ingredients in a skincare product for women, which have been shown to reduce wrinkles. The creative brief supplies the advertiser with a plan along which the advertising message will be developed. Using the objectives of the advertising as a basis, the message needs to be carried out using a particular format or framework. Now, let's understand what is creative message execution. Friends, the framework of execution refers to the message approach that will be used to present the advertising appeal to communicate the brand. Within the executional frame, an advertising appeal is used to express the message. According to Belk and Belk in 2007, the executional style refers to the manner in which an advertising appeal is used to communicate with the audience. Advertising appeals are used to elicit a response from the audience. Now, let's look into this message executional styles. Various academics have different opinions as to the classification of message execution versus advertising appeals, and some make no distinction. Various terms are used to refer to executional styles. First is straightforward execution. This executional style is also referred to as the factual message, as the straight sell execution provides basic information about the brand without employing feelings or special tricks. The straight sell is often used in conjunction with an informational or rational advertising appeal that sells high involvement products such as computers. A variation of the straight sell is advertisements containing scientific or technical support, such as advertisements where statistics are provided on the success rate of the product. The second is testimonials. Friends, the testimonial execution style entails a person with product experience providing a positive report. It is most effective when the person used in the testimonial is credible and the audience can relate to the message. Two types of endorsers may be used, namely typical persons and celebrities. Typical person endorsers are non-celebrities that are deemed credible, since they have experience of the product and are easy to relate to, according to Blackman. Many organizations make use of celebrity endorsers. Using celebrities or experts in testimonials is also known as authoritative executions. Film and television stars sports personalities and other famous people endorse a wide variety of brands. The popularity and likability of celebrities make them ideal for influencing consumers. Third is demonstrations. Friends, the demonstration framework shows the actual working of the product. The advantages and ease of consumption of the product can be shown clearly, as well as the effectiveness of the product. Television is the advertising medium best suited for this, and accordingly, many household appliance companies make use of it. In such a commercial, the character in the advertisement is generally the user. Fourth is a slice of life execution. It is also referred to as the problem-solution approach. Slice of life advertisements present an everyday situation where a person is faced with a consumption problem that occurs in daily life. The problem is then solved by using the advertiser's product. Generally, it depicts a social scenario where people discuss a specific problem and then someone provides a solution in the form of the advertised brand. The brand is then tried out and the results are always positive. The secret to successful slice of life advertisements is simplicity. The advertisement should focus on a key benefit that is presented in a realistic and memorable manner. The slice of life approach adds feelings and recognition to the basic provision of facts and allows the audience to identify with the situation. Friends, many household cleaning products are advertised using this approach. Fifth is dramatizations. This approach relates a short tell where the product serves as a main focus. Dramatization is a more theoretical version of slice of life, often showing the extremes of possible situations. Unlike slice of life, dramatization is suspenseful and rather complex. Television commercials are well suited for dramatization as a short movie format is often used. Coca-Cola has used dramatization for a successful campaign named Happiness Factory. This was shown on television and could be downloaded to consumers' cell phones also. Sixth is fantasy execution. Friends, the fantasy framework puts the characters in the advertisement or commercial in a realm where their dreams become a reality or they can enjoy an imaginary escape. It serves to place an ordinary product in a fun and exciting scenario which is usually very memorable. Seventh is animation execution. Animation approach that uses various animated characters to relate the brand message is growing in popularity. Techniques include cartoons, puppets, illustrations, or similar fictional creations. This method is primarily used in advertisements that are aimed at children, but it has also found a purpose in advertising directed at adults. Many of the characters used in animated advertisements become synonymous with the brand and retain its popularity. Eighth is comparison execution. Friends, comparative advertising entails the advertiser favorably comparing its brand with that of competing brands, and it allows the advertiser to focus on attributes of the brand, using one or sometimes a combination of executive styles. The message is presented through an advertising appeal. Advertising appeals are used to communicate the brand message in a manner that elicits a response from the target audience. Friends, now let us understand what is advertising appeals. advertising appeals are the cues that attract the attention of the audience and that attempt to influence the consumer in some way. The focus can be on the rational or emotional motives of the consumer or combination thereof. As most purchases contain both rational and emotional facets, advertisers recognize the need to sometimes combine the two appeals in advertising. Different types of advertising appeals involve. First is rational or informational appeals, which focuses on the consumer's functional needs and use premises such as convenience, economy, and health as benefits. Feature appeals concentrates on the primary attributes of the brand and are used to stimulate technically complex and high involvement purchases. Friends, in price appeals, the attention is on the favorable price of the product and its good value. An examination of the subset of rational appeals involves so many aspects like scientific or technical evidence provides technical or scientific information about the brand. An authoritative expert such as doctor or scientific body may be used to describe technical product features. News or educational appeals provide information on a new product or significant. Product features or popularity appeals use the key product benefit or the reputation of the brand to present the message. Friends, if the product feature is unique to the brand, this can be very effective. Second is emotional appeals. By eliciting an emotional response from the target audience, emotional appeals attempt to create a link between the brand and the consumer's psychological needs. This appeal is useful when rational differentiation between brands is difficult. Friends, appeals that focus on favorable emotions such as joy and success are termed feel good or positive emotional appeals. The opposite are fear appeals, which can be very effective as they can intimidate the audience and create tension. The subset of emotional appeals includes fear appeals, trigger strong emotional reactions and are useful for attracting attention. Extreme fear appeals tend to lead to message rejection as the audience does not want to feel bad. Guilt is also a negative emotion used in advertising and is coupled with a brand offering to relieve the viewer's feeling of guilt. Humor is the tool used most often in advertising. It has the advantage of intrusiveness and positive effect gained from humor spills over onto the brand. The problem is that the brand message may be overshadowed by humor, rendering the advertisement thereby ineffective. The next includes sex appeal, where the use of sex in advertising, like humor, has the advantage of attracting attention. Many organizations use sexually attractive decorative models to draw the attention of the audience. Using nudity or partial nudity in advertising are subjects of great controversy and should be approached with care, as many consumers are offended by overtly sexual nuances in advertisements. Now, let me conclude the session. Friends, creativity in advertising is crucial as the competition for the attention of the consumer is widespread. Effective advertisements satisfy the objectives of the advertiser and persuade the audience to take action. We have learned that the message strategy involved in the development of the advertising message is important for the advertiser. Preparing creative brief and the elements of the creative brief is the plan for the advertisement. We have also seen in this session the methods of advertising execution, including all the various executional styles available to advertisers. This was followed by an exposition of different advertising appeals that are used within the executional framework to reach the target audience. Hope from this session you have learned the importance and the way of creating messages. Hope you like the session. Thank you.